seacă, la poalele culmilor, la morminți și țapu, acolo vă fie sfârșitul, mormântul. Și gornici, bereznici, codreni și șumari, prin rugă și luptă, orbire și rană, păzit au, cruțat au al lemnului rost, inelele timpului cu veacul ce curg spre veșnicie.
Hi, I'm Tibor from Romanian atmospheric folk metal band Sur Austru, and you're listening Bloodshed with the Vampire on Metal Messiah Radio.
Tibor, thank you very much for taking time out for this interview. It's a great pleasure to have you here for the Metal Bloodshed with the Vampire on Metal Messiah Radio International.
Thank you for the opportunity. It's a great pleasure to us.
It's a pleasure for us to have you here. Tibor Kati, a multi-instrumentalist born in the beautiful city of Arad in the western Romania. Tibor, how was your early years starting in the music business, and who inspired you both in your national folk music and in metal?
My first experience with the music was when I was very kid, around of 10 year old, and I tried to play some guitars, but I don't really liked this way of folk music what I learned at school. And after, when I was 13, I start with the metal music, when I listened for the first time Death, Morbid Angel, Napalm Death, around 1988.
We know you are a very busy musician. Besides Sur Austru, you are part of different bands at the same time, like In Defiance, melodic death metal band, and Grime Goth Doom death metal band from Romania. Both, are these bands still active doing music and doing live shows?
Only the Grime Goth working now and has live shows. In Defiance, another band continue without me under another name, Terra Infernal. Just now I have Sur Austru in my first plan, and Grime Goth and Feralia. So it's only three projects right now.
Tibor, I just had the great opportunity to interview the Italian atmospheric black metal band Feralia,
where I talked to Reginos, Nebis, and Corura.
And I found out that you are their new frontman, and I want to congratulate you for being there, and I want to congratulate you also for their new album, Helios Manifestus. How are things going with the guys, and are you enjoying being on the road with them?
Yeah, it's a very cool project. I was enjoyed when the guys had songs, and they asked me if I want to play maybe one song or something, and they sent to me the songs. And when I heard the songs, I said to the guys, these songs are great, and if you want, I will make all the LP. In between the time, 2 weeks before, we had a show in Torino. It was our first debut show with Feralia, and also it was a really successful show.
Are you talking about the same night on October 26th when Feralia had their album release party together with your band Sur Austru, playing on the same night?
Yeah, it was in the same night.
So you was very busy doing a double duty that night.
No, it was okay. It was not too hard. It was an experience before, when I played in Negura Bunget a few years before, and we made tours with Grime Goth also, another my project, and was 2 months long tour, and play in every night with two projects, with Negura Bunget and with Grime Goth also, so it's not too hard.
Okay, Tibor, talking about Negura Bunget, you joined them, this great and legendary Romanian progressive folk atmospheric black metal band, in 2013, where you released 2 albums with them, Tao in 2015 and Z in 2016 with the death of, too bad to say this, I'm very sorry, of Gabriel Mafa Negro. In 2017, the band has ended as well. Tibor, how was your experience being a part of this legendary band, Negura Bunget, and how was, yes, your time working with Negro?
It was a salute, fabulous opportunity to play in Negura Bunget, and it was a great opportunity to learn from Negro about how to structure the band, how to concept, and how to manage everything in good way. So it was a very cool period. It was 4 years, around 300 shows, more than 250 shows in Europe and in North America. So I learned a lot. That was probably the best part of my life.
Okay, after the band that has split, Sur Austru came to rise, a new musical concept created from the ashes of the Transylvanian black metal pioneers Negura Bunget, gathering inspiration and emotion from aesthetics of nature, ancient lore, and forgotten ritual. Sur Austru is proposing a timeless journey into the mystical landscape of Transylvania. Tibor, could you please present us the band's current lineup?
The band lineup is me, Tibor Kati, at voice, guitar, and some other instruments like tulnik. Ovidiu Corodan is the bass player, another colleague from ex-Negura Bunget. He played also at some traditional instruments. We have two young and talented guys from our hometown, Mihai Florea at guitar, and Sergiu Nadaban at drums and percussion. And also we have a flute player and a keyboard player, Ionut Cadariu. In this formula, we have two collaborators, our ex-bandmate from Negura Bunget, Petrica Ionutescu, and we also have a good friend of us, mine. His name is Boric Dan Gabriel, who made some lyrics for us and with us. So this is the extended and lineup of Sur Austru.
Thank you very much for presenting us the current band lineup. Tibor, the band has a new album, debut album, under the name Meteahna Timpurilor, was via prestigious Italian label Avantgarde Music on 20th September 2019. This album will challenge the listener on the multiple levels, swinging between harsh, thunderous metal and beautiful soundscape, where the old traditional instruments are blending magically together. It is a tale of crying forest and dying nature and our collective struggles of getting back into the right path of celebrating and enjoying its divinity. Tibor, could you please, if you don't mind, present us the album tracking list of this great new debut album of the band?
Okay, so the first song of the Meteahna Timpurilor is Dincolo De Munte. It's mean beyond the mountain, and it's the most folklorical song from this album. We consider this one, it's a good kind of intro for the songs. The next song is Puhoaielor, and it's one of the fastest blackish doom song of the album. Mistuind, it's a very dark and very deep song inspired by our ex-leader Negru. It's a very deep song. The fourth song of the album is Bradul Cerbului, means the deer's fur. It's about a song of deforestation and destroying the animals in the Transylvania. So the next song is Jale, means kind of more mourning. It's another deep song. It's a kind of instrumental song, but it's very deep. So the most liked songs till now from the reviews and the internet, it's mean Dor Austru. Dor Austru, it's an 11-minute long song, I think the most progressive song from our album. And Timp Vernal, it's another kind of fast song, kind of Blackish Doom. And I like this song because in the middle part, it's a very, very psychedelic part. And I really enjoy this kind of psychedelic, you know, songs. The last song of the album, it's Jabracie, and it's about the deforestation, the Transylvanian deforestation, and it's about opening of the eyes, the people, the nature is our future, not the money, the rest, material things from now. So in few words, this is our album, Meteahna Timpurilor.
52 minutes of music delivered with the skills and passions. Tibor, I want to thank you very much for describing us the album tracking list. Meteahna Timpurilor offers the listener a multifaceted collection of songs. The style is one of the merged blackened distortion with textured folk, resulting in music that sounds state your desire for both. This is an album crafted from emotional response to the current state of the natural world, awash with rage and despair at the savage, dying state of nature, yet also alive with naturalist appreciation for the beauty and the uniqueness of what yet remains. Tibor, tell us, how was the preparation and everything gone with the songwriting, the time spent in studio, and yes, where and who did the mix and mastering, and who was responsible for the production of this album?
So the production of album was started in 2018 in May. So we start to recording the stuff and everything. It was a long process. Some songs was written in a period of Negura Bunget, so theoretically some songs was written for the next Negura Bunget. In this way, it was a faster process. So songs was composed. When everything was done, we finished the album in our studio and we recorded almost everything in our kind of home studio. And the big part of the work was made it by our drummer, Sergiu Nadaban, and I think he made a great work, and he made the mix, and part of recording the mix was finalized with the mastering in Torino with Rob Squalo, who made genius master, in my opinion, an old school mastering for our album. And this is was the process of working on the Meteahna Timpurilor.
Sur Austru premiered officially a video for the song
Dincolo De Munte
last July 31st. What a great music and what a great song. Tibor, please share with us and all, where was the shots of the video taken and how long was you busy doing it? And besides the video, the band released last August 28th for the song
Jabracie.
Could we expect more film videos coming in the next coming days or weeks?
Yes, our first video was Dincolo De Munte, the most folkish song, first song of Meteahna Timpurilor, and was filmed in Siria. Siria is 30 kilometers from our hometown, so it's in our region, and it was a great experience. We worked with a local, very famous team who made videos, and his name is Mix Team, and the process was only one day, but we worked a lot, early morning till end of the day. It was a long process, but I think it's okay, and the people generally like our effort. Our second video was Jabracie, and it was not a really video, it was more animated stuff. And we have prepared two videos for the future, and we see how many budget we will have to make real nature videos.
Tibor, but these two videos you're talking about, do you know already for which song will there be?
Yes, the next song will be Dor Austru. After Dor Austru, we'll release Bradul Cerbului.
Do you believe that we will still see their premiere before the end of this year?
I don't know exactly. We have some plans, and also in 1 month we'll have a symphonical show in Arad, local symphonic orchestra. So we have big plans, and I don't know which ones will be the priority. So I don't know if we'll be released this year or not, these two videos.
Okay, talking about, yeah, Philharmonic and orchestra, the band, the most ambitious project was to play the debut album with a full orchestra and full choir with more than 80 musicians involved. Share with us, please, this great experience the band had doing this, please, Tibor.
Yeah, it was a great experience in the middle of July, and it was a hard work. More weeks, a lot of members, it was 80, more than 80 persons, so it was interesting. And just before we start this event, it was an open-air festival, and in this festival we played our album with symphonic orchestra, and just before we start, it was a storm break, so it was almost devastated everything, and the people running away from the storm. But we start, and in a few minutes everybody is come back, and the sky was clear, kind of clear. So it was strange, but a very nice experiment.
You guys are planning to do it again with this orchestra?
Yes, in December 27th we will repeat, but this time indoor at our Philharmonic Orchestra in Arad.
The band already played at several festivals such as Rockstar in Romania, Cult of Party in Italy, Facchetti in Hungary. Okay, Exit Festival in Serbia, Steel Meet Steel in Germany, Bermagaden Fest in France, etc. And many gigs that took place in Romania. And the band has been very busy on the road this year, touring across Europe. And among this gigantic list of cities toured are also this great and beautiful city of Gouda, a Dutch city south of Amsterdam in the province of South Holland. How was your trip to the Netherlands and your staying there been? How did the Dutch fans respond to the band performance last weekend, November 3rd, and at the Cave, the best metal bar in Amsterdam, a couple days before, Tibor?
Yeah, it was a great experience in Amsterdam. To be honest, it was better than I expected. We played sometimes before with Negura Bunget, and I learned the Dutch audience is very hard to move, and they are very selective and not easy.
They are more
more reserved. You have to compare with the Germans, yes.
Yeah, exactly. They are more hard. But it was a very nice experience. All show was great. It was a lot of people sometimes, except Sunday, but it was okay for Sunday.
How did you get to play at the cave? I know the guys are very good there. The owner,
Aram.
The owner of the cave.
Yes, it was nice in Amsterdam. I don't know him before. We know our friends from Rakakant. It's our friends from Poland. They managed these three shows for us.
Okay, I understand. Continue with this interview. I see you have more shows scheduled for the coming week and weekend in Romania itself. My question now are these the album release shows? Will these shows be the band's last shows for 2019 as well?
Yeah, it will be special release shows. And we have prepared some videos and a special show for these shows. Romania.
But one question, are these going to be the last shows for Sur Austru for 2019?
We have also a festival in Buzău, and also we have some quests from Germany to play, but I don't know if we have to manage, because in that period the airplanes are very expensive and we need some time to prepare the symphonic orchestra. So I don't know if we will be more or not, but it's still 7 shows till the end of the year.
So Austru already have a mastery over many soft ambient texture that complement the thick, dirty, doomy black metal, owing much to flutes, certainly, but just as much to a basic understanding of how to create shifts in mood, of and when to let a monumental riff punch its way out, and when to buttress it with other layers. Meteahna Timpurilor is a very strong debut from what will hopefully become the next big name in the Romanian metal scene. Meteahna Timpurilor was released via the prestigious Italian label Avantgarde Music on 20th of September 2019. After almost 2 months that the album has been released, what are the reactions from the fans and media been, and how are the Italian avant-garde music responding to the promotion and supporting the band?
Till now, everything is working very well with avant-garde and with the promotion and everything. We received more than 30 reviews from everything from the world. The reviews are pretty cool. Generally, I think it's a good response. We had some interviews in some countries, and some festivals was interested by us. So I think we are on the good way.
Tibor, in how many format is this album available? And I hear that the gold edition LPs are officially sold out. Are there going to be more printed, or what other colors are there available on the vinyl?
So right now we have, for the first was pressed gold and black editions, and the digipack on CD digipack edition, the digital on Bandcamp. So probably in the future we will press more colors if we'll be the audience will be interested, but till now everything is okay. It's a lot of guys who buy directly from us from Bandcamp, so it's okay.
Romania is a country known for different great metal festival as Death Metal Supremacy, Folk and Metal Fest, Dark Bombastic Evening, Rock Extreme Fest, Old Grave Fest, November to Dismember Metal Fest, Ghost Gathering, etc. Will we see Sur Austru on the bill of one of these festivals in the coming near future, Tibor?
Probably, yes. I don't know if next year we will play in some from these festivals, but in the past, for example, we played the Rockstadt Extreme Fest and Transylvanian Fest, so probably in the next year will be the next festivals, I don't know. We try to prepare everything for the next year, and we will play in some festivals next year. I don't know in which one, but we'll play definitely.
Tibor, my last question. We know the band has already booked for the German Black Metal Festival open air in the woods outside Berlin, somewhere in the area. Besides this one, what else will the band be doing for 2020 in support of this great new album? And when will we be able to see the next album of Sur Austru?
So for the next year, we have confirmed 6 festivals in Europe, generally in Germany. And the next album will be released definitely next year in 2020, in September, October, probably. We have also prepared the songs. In the period of January and February, we will start the work of the new song in our studio again, and hope it will be a fast process. Yeah, because we have experience. We worked before in some studios. I worked before. Sergiu worked before in studios, and everything is working. So we have some plans for 2020.
That's a great new. Haven't you booked already 6 festivals? Don't you want to share with us which festivals they are? I mean, besides the Black Metal Festival in Germany?
The rest of the festival don't announce us, and I don't want to break their opportunity to announce us.
So, okay, besides the 2 videos that you still have pending to release anytime this year or early next year for this album yet, Meteahna Timpurilor, I really wish you all the best with this great new album. I want to thank you very much, Tibor, once again to have made this interview possible. And I want to hand you over the microphone of Madam Saya Radio International for you to invite all your friends, all your fans to support the band, to buy this great new full-length debut, a long-awaited masterpiece, Meteahna Timpurilor, and also to attend the shows the band has already scheduled. Tibor, the microphone is all yours.
Thank you so much for this opportunity, and I want to say to everybody who listening, Bloodshed with the Vampire on Meta Radio, Messiah. Have a great evening.
Tibor, I mean, say hello to everybody in the band. Thank you very, very much. I appreciate your time. We are very honored to have this great opportunity to talk to you. Thank you very much once again.
We thanks for this opportunity. Stay metal.
And like always say, metal on. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.